just a mock-up. We're going to incorporate, we're going to add a interactive feature, which will be this fish moving back and forth along the page. I'm not the best at explaining things. I'm going to try my hardest, and I will answer any questions that you have. Just leave a comment in the video, and I will get back to you. I'm also going to provide a file which you can download and print, and that'll be on my website. That's just deniselush.com. So we are going to need to cut out three pieces. I'm not using the Good Dilutions cardstock for this, mixed media cardstock, because you're not going to see it, so I don't want to waste my good stuff. I love Dilutions mixed media paper, and I think I only have one sheet left, so I'm going to save that for doing the tree, like the little plant life and the fish and the accessories that are going to cover up the mechanism that allows the fish to move back and forth. So to start off, you are going to need to cut out a piece of paper. I'm using just regular cheap cardstock that you get at Michael's. You can get a pack of, I don't know, maybe 50 sheets in a pack. So the first piece you're going to cut out is going to be 9 inches by 2 inches. And then you're going to take your scoreboard and you're going to score it at 6/16 of an inch. And then you're going to score it again at 1/2 inch in from the edge. And then to make it easy, just flip the piece of paper around, like once you've cut it out, flip this piece out, and again, score at 6/16 and 1/2 inch. And that'll be your first piece. So that piece is actually just this plain piece that's on the front that these plants are attached to. And you'll see how it is scored here, so it bends over. And then the next piece you're going to cut is this piece here with a slot in it that allows this to slide back and forth. So that piece of paper or cardstock is going to be 7 7/8 of an inch long and 1 3/4 wide. Then you're going to measure up from the bottom 1 inch, and then you're going to measure in from the left side 7/8 of an inch, and measure in on the right side 1 7/8 of an inch. And you want this cutout to be not too big, but you don't want it so tight that the paper's going to have a hard time moving back and forth. So about 1/16 of an inch will be plenty. You can see it's just a little cutout. So now for this piece, again, like I said, this is just a mock-up. I wanted to see if I could actually make this work. So this is just single, but to have more, like, this is so flimsy. So to make it more sturdy, I thought we would cut this piece. So this base piece that you're going to be constantly moving back and forth will be thicker. So we'll cut an L shape, but this bottom piece will actually be twice the width of what we actually wanted, so we can fold it in half and make this thicker and more sturdy. So this piece is going to be 7 1/2 inches long, and then right here, this is actually going to be 3/4 inch thick. So to double that, we'll do 1 1/2 inches. And then this, I guess you want to call it an arm maybe, the part that the fish will be attached to. That piece is about, well, the whole height you'll have to cut. This side is going to be 4 1/4. But that'll give you your L shape. And then when you cut it out, you'll fold it in half. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut out some pieces for myself. And then I won't do the scoring until I turn the video camera back on, but I'll just get the pieces cut and ready, and then I'll come back. Okay, so if you go onto my website, or the Ranger website, you will see PDF files for these cutouts. Thought I would make it easy and just draw it out. Solid lines mean where you cut, and the dotted lines is where you will score the paper. So I'm going to go ahead and cut these out and show you how it's done. Actually, we'll do the other one first. So this one is for the slider that goes out to the side. One thing I thought about doing, when this is on the art journal page, and it really doesn't matter because I think the idea of the fish floating around, it is so cute that I really don't think you're going to really be looking at this part that's moving the fish. And when I did the mock-up, I kind of liked it because it kind of gave it that childlike, that you could tell that that's what was moving it, and to me it just kind of added to the whimsy. So I'm trying to decide if I just want to leave it as paper, or I saved some plastic, some harder plastic from some packaging from, I can't remember what it was. I think it was some Tim Holtz words or something. So this is sturdy. So I'm thinking, instead of using cardstock, I may cut this arm off and replace it with a piece of plastic. And that way you can't actually see the arm. You'll just see the fish moving around. So it is totally up to you what you want to do. You can leave it as cardstock and leave it white, or you can paint it to blend in with the background. So when you do, you could take your paints, like same color paints. I wouldn't worry about the leaves and everything. I mean, there's no need to be that picky. But I mean, you could. You could just paint this blue and then do one vine going up. Or just do it all solid blue. And it's just blue going back and forth. So it's totally up to you. But now that my background is painted and it looks very vibrant, I'm definitely not going to leave it white. I'm thinking it's either going to go blue or it's going to go plastic. And I'm really wanting to try the plastic. Because if it fails and it doesn't work, then I'll just make another arm. So I'm going to go for the plastic arm. And then you can see if mine works before you want to try it. So the arm will have to be, I think it's four and one quarter. So 4 1/4 by 3/4. And again, that probably depends on what you're putting on the top. Like, I'm going to be stamping this fish from Diane's stamp set. This one here, Plenty of Fish in the Sea. I'm going to be stamping at this guy and putting him on the top of this arm. So I wanted it, I just feel more secure with it being a little wider. Again, you can try it with a smaller arm if you want and see if it works. And it's not going to be that hard to make a new arm and replace it if you don't like it. It was one of the easiest things we had to do. So I am going to cut. Actually, I'm going to use the cutting board. I'm better at that. First, I'm going to cut off the outside. I used to have so much of this hard plastic. I had like one of those drawer bins that's like there's 3 or 4 drawers on wheels. I had one of those plastic drawers that was about this thick, full of this plastic stuff. I used to scrapbook and I had tons of packaging from like Sizzix dies and embellishments, and I would keep it all. Such real hoarder. I have a hard time throwing things out because I look at it and I'm like, oh, I could use that for this. I could make this, or maybe one day I'll do this. And it just builds up. So I threw it all out. I haven't let go of my scrapbooking stuff yet, though. I still can't bring myself to do that. Maybe one day. I'd rather give it to like a charity or a school or a daycare. I don't want to just throw it out. That's too sad. Just getting a straight edge first. So it's actually not the easiest to cut with a paper trimmer. It's easier if you start in the plastic than trying to start off the plastic and go through it. It's going to move on. Darn it. That's twisted. I'm just going to use my scissors to finish it off. I'm going to leave the little extra on, like it's about a quarter of an inch longer, but I'm going to leave it because it's clear, so it's going behind the fish. For now, I'm going to leave the arm on there, the colored arm, because the clear is not going to show up on the camera. So I need to put this somewhere where I won't lose it. Okay, so for now, I'll save the solid cardstock so you can see it. So to put this together, I want to round the outside corner. Because the journal has little rounded corners. So I'm only going to round this corner because this is not going to go all the way in. So I made this a little bit shorter than the journal page because I didn't want to have to worry about it falling over, and I didn't want too close to the center because I didn't want it to be too hard to close the page. That's why we did it shy of the width of the page. I'm going to round that corner. I'm also going to round the corner of this one. That's 1 inch up from the bottom. So these two corners. Not sure what width I have. So I'm going to round it with it folded. That'll be good. I'm going to take these plants off so you can see. So for this one, just putting some foam tape. I'm going to zoom in. Okay, so we added foam tape along the inside of the half inch score line. So that will go on top. And then you can add double-sided tape. You can remove this tape. I'm trying to decide if I want to remove it or not. I wonder if I should wait. And we can adhere this down, but don't go any further. Don't add the double-sided tape to the other side yet. I'm going to add a little bit along the bottom just to keep it up. Actually, I'm going to wait until we get it put together, and then I'm going to decide if I want some because it sinks down on the bottom. but I may not care. So I'm gonna wait until we have it put together and placed on the journal. And that can be a last minute addition. So on this one, that is gonna go like this. The arm, okay, so that is covering the piece with the slot. If we just slide this down, you will see that how it's gonna move. I gotta remember. Yeah, so it's gonna, you wanna push it up against the top of the slot. So we can add tape. As long as you have thin tape, don't, because if you have the wide, it's gonna be in the way. But if you have the thin stuff and you put it right along the very bottom, and then put a little bit up here. Just don't put it too close to where the arm is because then it might stick. So don't come any closer. Like, I'm gonna put a small piece. I'm gonna keep the arm on so I can see where it's gonna go. I'm just going to cut off the tiniest piece. It's probably about a quarter of an inch. Not even. 1, 2, about 3/8. No, 3/16. Yeah, about 3/16. And I'm going to put that right there. And I'm going to put another piece. I'm not going to start it right to the tape. I'm going to go up a bit. See how I left some space? Now this side you can add tape the whole way down because the arm is only going over that far, 7/8 of an inch in. So you can adhere double-sided tape all along that side. I'm going to leave the arm in place. Which arm do I want to add first? Remove the tape. Sometimes I'm so nervous because the stuff is so sticky that I will just peel back if I can. I'm getting both. There we go. I'll just peel back a little bit. And get it in place. Push it down. So what this is sticking to is your tab. So this tape is sticking along this folded tab here. Now with that in place, you can see the red tape is out, so just grab a hold of it, slide it up. That's down. Now for this side, make sure that arm is where it needs to be. So the top of this lines up with the top of the slot that you cut out. So put it, don't leave it in open position, put it in closed position. And push it up against the top of the slot. And you should be safe to remove these pieces of tape. And a small, it's sticking to me. And then just let this fall. See if it did it. Yay! I hope yours worked too. Yeah, so maybe we will put some foam tape on the bottom, because if not, that can fall down there. So what we could do is add a little bit of foam tape. I'm going to add some right there and maybe down here a little bit. I'll just put it down along the bottom edge. So if you were smart and watched this video before starting yours and didn't play along with me, you'll know not to tape this up first. But it's not that hard to get out because there's lots of movement. So it's easy to get your fingers in there. But before I take that other side of the tape off, I'm going to get the other one in place. Right along the bottom edge. And we can remove it. Make sure your arm is up out of the way. Let's see if it's still good. Oh, it's moved. Oh, frigate egg. Arm move and got behind the sticky tape. Still works. Okay, so that's one mechanism for one side. Okay, so we have our first slider, and that one's going to go this way. Super cute, hey? Now for the second slider, this one is going to go up and down. Now it's not going to cover the whole page. This is just what I was using to check, see how to do it and if I can make it work. So for this one, I'm going to fold it in half like we did the other one. And again, apply some adhesive. This piece is going to go on the arm. So we're going to fold the first line on each side. So imagine this is attaching to the arm. We're going to fold it towards the arm, the first crease. And then accordion style, you're going to flip that piece back on itself. And then do the same thing on the other side. And when you fold them, make sure, okay, this is what it looks like if you can see it. Okay. So you have to make sure that when folded down, that these don't overlap. If you can see, there's like a space. That is what we want. So then we're going to glue this piece right here. I do apologize if I'm not the best at explaining. I'm not a good teacher. I like to do, and then I just, me finding words to explain how things are done, it just doesn't come easy to me. So hopefully you can follow along and understand what I'm doing. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. And I will answer to the best of my abilities, but hopefully watching the video makes it clear. So, and that's our piece there. Then you can glue, just put on this first half of the arm, glue on the first piece. And stick that down. Do not put glue on the other half. Just going to hold it there for a bit until it catches. Okay. And do the same thing on the other side. And that's that one. So it'll look like that. It'll look like a T. So this one works like, say this is your journal page. These will go through the notch that you cut. Oops. And then you will open this up. And you'll attach the piece that you want to slide back and forth. Okay. And this piece that we cut will go on the back of your journal page. And it's just a guide so the slider doesn't move too far one way or the other. That's all that piece does. So you'll just put a bit of glue on each end, avoid the center. And you'll just stick it down on the back of your journal page. That's just a guide. And put it down there. You can put it up here further if you like. It makes no difference. Just don't put it up at the top. Just make sure that wherever you place it is not above the slider once it's down as far as it can go. Because if you put it up here, once that slider tries to go back up, it's going to be in the way. So put your slider down as far as it can go, and then this piece can be glued anywhere below it. And that's the two sliders. Okay. So with this looking like a T, see that? We're going to put it through the slot, and then you open it up, and then the thing will get attached to that, and that's what's going to make it slide. Now if you want to be really picky, whatever you decide to paint on this, you could always do some blue. So when you pull down, there's still blue behind there. And I'm bad enough that I may do that. So just to keep this from wanting to go side to side, though it's pretty good. Now I just have temporary adhesive on there. When you glue this down, use a good strong glue. I just have that temporarily in place. So now that other strip that we cut, that was 3/4 by 3 inches, we're just going to put some glue on each end and put it down there. Don't put glue close to here because you want the arm to be able to slide. It's just on the two ends so it has a guide. There you go. One slider. And our other slider. Isn't that cute?